Hi everyone, in this video we're going to have a look at the Elementor add-ons that are going to be a great help for you if you're running a blog, a news portal, or just a website with a similar purpose. So these are the plugins that are going to help you to organize your posts in a very convenient and a beautiful looking way. Create mega menus and organize the mega menu items in a way so you can present your posts and gallery and media items right there in the mega menu. Also, there is a plugin that's going to allow your visitors to leave reviews and are going to be able to create their review forms. Also, we're going to have a look at the plugin that allows you to work with a dynamic content, create custom post types, and much more. Also, you'll be able to add a search widget that's going to allow the visitors to search across your entire website and find the exact post that they need using the keywords. And we'll also look at some widgets that go in JetElements plugin, that is the most advanced add-on for Elementor page builder and probably the most famous one. So now we're going to have a closer look at each of these plugins separately. And to demonstrate you the features of these plugins, I'm using 24 historical multi-purpose news portal Elementor WordPress theme that you can get if you follow the link in the description under this video, and also you can get all of the plugins mentioned in this video if you follow the links that I've put in the description. So this theme is perfect for blogs, news portals. It goes with multiple skins and you can pick the one that you need for your specific idea. And we're going to start with the first add-on for Elementor that I totally recommend to everyone who runs a blog, and it is called JetBlog. So you can download this plugin if you follow the link in the description, and it's got a lot of features. Actually, it goes with the number of widgets that I added to the default widgets in Elementor Page Builder. These are four simple widgets, but they are very simple to navigate, they're intuitive, and they allow you to create these really beautiful designs to organize your posts in tiles and add the navigation arrows animations. So the smart list and smart tiles. So smart tiles are more about using images, using imagery, so you can present your post using this thumbnail. Like that. So this is just the presentation page for the features of this blog, but we're going to proceed to Elementor editor and try and create something on our own. So this is a feature called a news ticker, and this widget allows you to create a section that's going to be presenting one post at a time, and they're going to be switching each other, showing only one post, and it's mostly used to attract the attention of users to the most interesting and the most trending news on your website. And also the video playlist that allows you to create a section to present videos from YouTube, Vimeo, and you can stylize it so it matches the design of your entire website. So now we're here in Elementor editor, and I've opened the homepage of one of the skins that go in 24 historical WordPress theme. And as we scroll down, we can see that all across the homepage in this skin, there are used the widgets that you have in JetBlog plugin. Let me just scroll down and show you how the page looks. So you see it's all made of the blocks, which is now is smart list. There are smart tiles too. And here at the bottom of the page, we have a stylized video player. So there we go. Here you can see a number of examples of how the designs that you create with JetBlog might look like. Let's look at the settings. So here you can choose the layout, minimum height, and the width of this entire block. Also, you have query controls. And if you wish, you can use custom query, or you can filter the posts that are going to be displayed in this widget, in the post styles widget. You can query these posts using the settings that are presented in here. Also, there are styling options. There you go, a number of them. So you can change the style of pretty much any of the elements that you have here in this block. There we go, smart post styles and smart post lists have pretty much the same styling and query settings. And here you can see the new sticker. Here it goes, this little tiny section at the top. And you've got here arrows that allow you to switch between the posts. So the settings are also extremely simple and easy. Now let's quickly have a look at the settings that we have for the video player. So as you see, the player itself is pulled out from YouTube. So it's a default YouTube player. So here you simply add the URL of the video and you fill in the list of the items that you want to be shown in your video playlist. Here, simply the links and the title, and that's it. It pulls out the link from the video hosting. And then it simply shows you here all the videos that you put in the list of items in the settings. Also, here are the settings for the player itself and some styling options. So it was pretty much it for the JetBlog plugin. Now, I hope that you are interested enough to go to the description under this video and try this plugin out for yourself. And now it's time to proceed to the next add-on for Elementor that I have for today, and it's gonna be JetMenu. JetMenu plugin allows you to add media library elements and just pretty much any section that you want to add to your mega menu. If we click on the live demo, you can see the examples of designs that can be created with the help of this add-on. So you see it's complex drop-down menus. You see there are lists and you can add badges, you can add icons to your menu items. So there is a complex, huge multimedia mega menu item like that. You can add videos, video playlists, you can add galleries, you can add blog items, you can even add the product showcase if you have an online store, and you can even add a contacts page with the contact form and some other information right here, and the contact form is going to be absolutely working right from the mega menu item. So here, if we have a look at the mega menu created in the 24 historical WordPress theme, you see that here we have the showcase of the posts, a working slider with the navigation, like that. Here we can see different kinds of the post showcase that we can create. So a simple drop down. Also the list, mega menu item. Let me get back to the WordPress dashboard. So what you need to do here is to go to appearance menus. And here you choose the menu that you want to edit. I have quite a bunch of them in here and I want to edit the main menu. That is the main menu at the top, and we click select. So it opens up this menu for us. So here we can see the menu items, all of them. So this is how drop-down menu items are presented. They're just like sub items, as you can see there. Okay, what do we want to do? Let's say we want to edit the business item. So if JetMenu for current location is enabled, we can click on this JetMenu icon right here that is appearing once I hover over the item. Like, you simply click on it. Here we have a number of settings for the item itself. These settings include the position of the mega menu item. So this is the section that opens once you hover over the item in the menu. So here you can set the width, and you can choose the icon for the mega menu item. So there it goes. So you choose the icon right here, you select the color. It works pretty much the same way for badges. Here, what you need to do is to type the text that's going to be shown on your badge. Select the badge color and the badge background color. If you leave this field empty, the badge simply is not going to appear. And you also have miscellaneous settings. which include hide item navigation label and the possibility to set custom padding for this item. Also, with the help of JetMenu plugin, you can create vertical mega menus. But we're not going to have a closer look at those in this video. I just can show you the vertical menu right here. It's pretty much the same, and it's created pretty much the same way as the horizontal menu is. The only difference is that all the main menu items are stacked on top of each other. So we're not going to create it now, but you just know that there's a possibility to do that. Now here, back to the content tab here in this little pop-up window. What I need to do is to make sure that mega submenu enabled option is set to yes, and then we simply click on this big edit mega menu item content button. And it just takes us to Elementor editor and allows us to work with the contents of this mega menu item as with a regular section in Elementor. So this is how you create mega menu items with the help of JetMenu plugin for Elementor, and you can get this plugin in the description under this video. Yet another plugin that will take the user experience on your blog to a next level is called JetSearch. This plugin allows you to add a search field to your page and allow the user to search across your entire website using keywords. Like in this example, you could search using one of the types of posts. Like you could search across posts on your website, across pages, across products. Like you could choose one post type to search within this post type. And here you could pick the categories. And here you could pick the taxonomy and help filter your search results using the taxonomy. Or you could also search across your entire website. And the great thing about this widget is that it comes with the Ajax support. It means that it allows you to get search results instantly, right after you type your keyword in here in the search field, and you don't need to refresh the page. And you can view all of the search results using the pagination over there. And the look of this field is absolutely customizable. And once you click on any of the results, you'll be taken to the specific post. As for the next plugin, for today, it is JetReviews, which is going to allow you to create similar review forms for the users to fill in. There are different styling settings. There are different possibilities to create various designs with this plugin. So this is how this form can look like for the user once they need to fill this in. So if you want to have reviews by your users on your website, you definitely need to check JetReviews plugin out. Now the next one is JetEngine, and this plugin and its possibilities and the features it has are really huge, and I think that we will not have enough time in this video to cover all of it. I'm simply going to name a couple of these, the most impressive features that this plugin has. So with JetEngine plugin, you're able to create custom post types, which is extremely useful if you're on a blog and you want to run multiple post types for multiple kinds of the content that you have on your blog. What it also does is makes creating custom fields extremely easy and fast. Also, custom taxonomies, which is almost as useful as creating custom post types, because it's going to help you categorize the content that you have on your blog or on the news portal in a new amazing way. So while working with custom post types, you'll also be able to create custom listing items and then reveal them in the listing grid, which is really a new way to present your content to your users. And with the dynamic calendar functionality, it's extremely easy and convenient to manage the dynamic events that you create on your website. And the last but not least is a JetElements plugin, which in itself has almost 50 unique new widgets for Elementor that are not present in the default version of Elementor. It is compatible with free version of Elementor, and all of these add-ons that we have had a look in this video are also compatible with the free version of Elementor, so you don't need Elementor Pro to use any of these. So these are the widgets that you have in JetElements package. So there are also the functionality to create post carousels, post sliders, post grids, etc., and much more, including maps, so you can add Google Maps, countdowns, product showcases, a possibility to add contact forms, which is a pretty useful functionality if you run a blog. So it allows you to also create the subscription forms and connect these forms with MailChimp. Also a possibility to create pricing tables, simple tables, timelines to showcase the progress that you've made with your website over a certain period of time, to add portfolios, weather widget, which is quite useful if you're on a news portal, so you can also showcase some information about the weather changes and weather forecast on your website. So another video player, an audio player, drop bars, multiple kinds of galleries, and many other widgets that's gonna make your pages look more sophisticated, more interesting, and simply more convenient for your users. So that was pretty much it for the video on the best add-ons for Elementor that you need if you run a blog or a news portal, website, or something of its kind. So thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and you're gonna go to the description and check out all of the links to the add-ons and to 24 historical WordPress theme. Thank you for watching.